Hello everyone, welcome back to another informative video. In this video we are going to take a look on the corn and the beetroot growing in the fabric container. So please be reminded that these two crops that I've planted in these two containers are basically for experimental purpose, right? Just as the sweet potato that we recently reaped. So let us first take a look at the corn. So as you can see, the corn, they are fairly tall now, and this corn was planted on the 8th of October, so this is going to make roughly about 2 weeks, right? 14 days since they have been planted, and as you can see, they have grown quite a bit. They are roughly about a little over one feet now, right? And they are looking well. There are no signs of insects so far. They are looking green and very pretty. They are not showing any signs, any symptoms of nutrient deficiency, right? As you can see, we have fair, I think it's 100% germination. All the corn seeds that were planted germinated, basically. So as you can see, this one in front of us here, this one has two, but the rest of them is basically one. I can basically choose to thin out this container, as in to remove some of the corn from this container, but I've decided to leave it as is, just to see how the heel will be affected, or what kind of heel I will get. Right, I understand from a more fundamental perspective that planting distance can be a issue here, but nevertheless it is an experiment. Of course they'll be competing for the resources that we have there, soil resources, but in terms of sunlight, you will find that they're not going to be that much overcrowded, right? Because of the shape of their leaves. I know their leaves grow, their leaves are not very they are not broad, right? So you don't find that they are creating too much of a shade to each other, right? So another thing I want to mention with the corn is that the corn is basically it's both self-pollinated and it can be cross-pollinated as well. So what that means is that you can have one corn seed and it grows and give you corn, right? As well as if you have more than one, like I have here, you'll find that pollen can move from one plant to the next plant, right, and causing cross pollination. But nevertheless, you'll basically all the plants in this pot here, they are basically the same in terms of genetics. So but I leave the genetics for another video. Remember I told you that I am going to talk to you about reusing seeds, so I'm going to use the same corn to basically discuss that with you, and that video will be coming shortly, right? So again, this is the corn. They are growing well. I water them every day. As you can see, the soil is pretty moist, looking pretty moist, right? And they are 2 weeks old and they are just measuring a little over 1 feet, maybe about 16, ranging from 12 to 16 inches, right? So yeah, that is how they look so far. And let us move on to the beetroot. So the beetroot is looking wonderful so far as well. The beetroot, in terms of the age, these are growing roughly about 20 days, yeah, roughly about 20 days. These were planted about the, I think about the 2nd of October. Yeah. So they are going roughly about 20, 21 days. Yeah. So, this is what they look like so far. Again, I'm having no signs of insects, no disease issues. However, you can also see that we have a bit of overcrowding happening. And because it is also an experiment, just as the corn, I'm basically leaving it high density like this to see what will happen, right? To see what will happen. I can already see that, you know, some plants are being, you know, overshadowed, right? But as I said, I want to see the yield that I'll get on this high density planting in the container. So in another trial or another experiment, we will plant less beetroot seeds in a container and basically compare the yield, right? So this is how it looks at 20 days, and they are growing well. So so remember earlier I told you that I'm going to be going to Jamaica. So basically these two pots, the beetroot and the corn, I'm going to put them a bit closer, you know, so the wife can water them, right? So what I'm going to do is, before I leave, I'm going to put some fertilizer in the pot, right? And I'm going to put, you know, ensure that I spray it before I leave with some insecticide and fungicide, and hope that the fertilizer that I put in the containers will suffice, you know, while my wife continues to water, and until I come back, right? So if you have any questions, any comments, please put them in the comments here. Please remember to subscribe to the channel. And again, these two crops, they are basically experiment in the container. See you again in another video. Bye-bye.